canceled.
Over the past decade, cancel culture has taken the internet by storm. Some have fallen victim, some have made it through to the other side, but could the possibility of being canceled slowly stifle freedom of speech?
Because of cancel culture, there have been important conversations around topics that aren't normally talked about.
However, there are cases where the people of the internet don't have all the facts and perhaps took on the role of judge and jury without having an accurate picture of the story. I will admit, it's had its moments of good things like Me Too movement, yeah. Oscars so white, things like that, but we need to chill out. The world of sports has come to a halt in order to bring light to racial injustices in the shooting of Jacob Blake.
The NBA, WNBA, MLS, MLB, and NHL all stopped playing.
It was expected that the NBA and WNBA would return play on Thursday, but instead they took the day to reflect and continue to protest. The players met yesterday morning and have decided that they will continue the playoffs, most likely starting this weekend.
I think that it was definitely like, it's a big move because, I mean, there's a lot at stake in each one of these games, like the behind the scenes as well, like the business aspect of basketball. So there have been a lot of like placing pause on that probably made some people unhappy.
Yeah.
But they're paying attention now.
Exactly.
Tensions between China and the U.S. continue to rise.
China completed a military exercise that launched multiple medium-range missiles into the South China Sea, which is typically not militarized. The missiles were fired off because China said a U.S. U-2 spy plane had entered a no-fly zone without permission during a live-fire naval drill conducted by China in the Bohai Sea off its north coast.
In response, Mark Esper, the U.S. defense chief, said China has repeatedly fallen short to promise to abide by international laws, noting China seems to be flexing its muscles the most in Southeast Asia. Are we headed into World War III? That's a scary thing that's starting to happen there. It's like, I think that maybe once the elections happen, there's gonna be a different tone on that situation in general.
Depending on who's in office.
All right, y'all, we're back with more Tiger King news. I don't know if I'm excited about it, but
Joe Exotic's husband, Dylan Passage, revealed that Exotic's legal team is looking into a possible presidential pardon for the jailed star. Exotic was jailed in January on animal abuse charges and as a conspirator in a murder-for-hire plot against his rival, Carol Baskin. And if you're wanting more Tiger King, season 2 of the show is now being filmed, where it will tell a little bit of the former zookeeper's arrest and what happened afterwards. Man, I'm sorry, Joe Exotic belongs in jail. Like,
you think?
Yes. If not for the murder for hire plot, like, I admit he was kind of coaxed into that by people that just didn't like him, which was unfortunate.
Yeah.
They took advantage of that situation. But the animal abuse charges, yeah, you deserve to sit in jail.
Yeah,
there.
I could see that.
This is Macaulay Culkin then, and this is him now. Feel old yet? Culkin, who is most known for playing Kevin in the Home Alone movies, tweeted on Wednesday, "Hey guys, wanna feel old? I'm 40. You're welcome." Culkin was 10 years old when he starred in Home Alone. He turned 40 on Wednesday. Whatever, Macaulay, you will always be that mischievous 10-year-old boy that we had grown up watching. Happy belated birthday. Jesus, he's 40 years old. Oh my God.
Yeah, I mean, people get old.
I know.
People get old. Life moves on, right?
Anyone else find themselves hitting the snooze button more since quarantine started? I know I have. The main culprit could be your electronics. Well, here's some tips from neuroscientist and IBL creator Ben Ryan on how to get better sleep.
If you want to get better sleep, here are some tips. First off, avoid looking at digital screens like TVs, laptops, and cell phones right before bed, which you're probably doing right now. So in your brain, there's an area called the suprachiasmatic nucleus, which uses the light signals from your eyes to control your circadian rhythm. So when you put a bright phone screen in front of your eyes before bed, your suprachiasmatic nucleus tells your brain that it's daytime, and this can make it really hard to fall asleep. Second, only spend time in your bed when you're sleeping. A lot of people treat their bed like a couch, where they eat dinner in it, they do homework and watch TV in it, and that's not good for your sleep. When you spend a lot of time doing things in your bed, your brain gets used to being alert when you're there. That can make it really hard for you to fall asleep at night. Good luck tonight.
I feel like we just need to have a lockbox for our phones at night.
Yeah.
You know?
Like a little robot that's like, it's time for bed, give me your phone, because even
a
if
robot?
I
had, that's
yeah,
like,
or something.
I mean, I don't know about a robot. I'm a little scared of a robot coming in saying, give me your phone.
You're right, true. Thanks for tuning in to the Daily News with us.
My name is Tanner.
I'm Sherry.
And we will see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.